We start our freshmen with a introductory seminar that is Holocaust and Human Behavior. It's a beautiful place to start because with the journey of facing history, beginning with identity and group formation, these are freshmen who are not only in their first days of freshman year of high school, which you all may remember with great pain, but furthermore, they're coming to us from, you know, countless schools within our district and outside of it. So they are absolutely steeped in the moment of who am I and who am I going to be and how much of that is in my control and how are these people seeing me and how do I see myself. So it's a perfect place to start. I should also note that we made the decision early on that rather than compromising what we wanted to do with Facing History to the district and state standards that we had to address, they actually take a full humanities curriculum that meets the state and city standards. And we have, on top of that, a Facing History seminar so that we can do exactly what we want to do. So we do a beautiful essential Holocaust and Human Behavior seminar in the fall of freshman year. In the spring of sophomore year, with the help of various program associates, we've developed a course that now looks at the Armenian genocide, South Africa under and after apartheid, with a particular focus on justice in the TRC, and this year Northern Ireland, ending with some look at current events, including Darfur and other issues, really looking at ideas of what history is and how that informs justice and how memory and legacy are a part of justice and storytelling and so on. In junior and senior year, Facing History gets embedded in our humanities curriculum in a variety of electives. So my colleagues, Joe Hicks and Saul Fusner, who are over there, have developed courses that use Eyes on the Prize to teach American government and ideas of citizenship and race in American history, to look at that at contemporary, well, U.S. history since Reconstruction through the lens of Native American history. There's a course that uses Facing Today and those materials through Facing History, and really infuses also the questions and themes throughout all of our junior and senior year electives. In senior year, our students, as I believe Linda described, we have students graduate by exhibition. Often there are projects that they have to do in order to demonstrate their readiness to be successful in college and as citizens. And so every senior has to do what we call a senior social action project. So in the beginning of their senior year, they need to identify an issue of can be local, national, international scope that means something to them. And then for the rest of the year, with the help of a faculty mentor and workshops taught by my colleagues, they have to do something about that issue. So there is a research component, but more importantly, we ask them to go out into the community to link with people in New Haven who may be doing work related to the work they want to do, to design their own project that is really going to accomplish something toward their end of their social action project. A small little anecdote there, I was once mentoring a senior who said, came to me early in her decision making about what she wanted to do, and she said, well, I was thinking first about doing a project on race relations, but I'm worried that I'm not going to be able to fix that. So I said, you know, that's okay. You don't have to fix it. So anyway, they work over the course of their senior year on their project and what they want to do, and ultimately that ends in an exhibition of the work they've accomplished. Those projects themselves have become a huge part of the culture of our school, so now we have sophomores and juniors who will say to us, well, you know, when I'm a senior, here's what I want to do for my social action project. They begin planning, they start scoping out mentors, they really get excited about it well ahead of time.